Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. To begin with today, we have the usual updates with some upcoming launch information. Then Boca Chica infrastructure plus the latest with Starship development and SN8 testing soon. Let's head straight in and get up to date. The launch of Sentinel 6, supposed to happen on November 10th, has been delayed until the end of the month. Kathy Luders gave some more information about Sentinel 6 by tweeting, "We are looking at dates after the launch of Crew 1 on November 14th, which is still on track." SpaceX tweeted that they had completed a static fire for the upcoming GPS-3 Space Vehicle 4 launch, which should now be Thursday, November 5th. M. Ray Kelly posted a series of tweets about some information that was said by SpaceX's Hans Koenigsmann. He said, "After GPS scrub, we saw that engines 1 and 2 were starting early. Nothing immediately obvious was found, but engines were pulled and sent to McGregor. We were actually able to replicate it in Texas. It did the same thing on the test stand. Led to the discovery of relief valve blockage. Masking lacquer left over from build process was caused, cleaning off solved the problem. Found more of the build process lacquer on other engines, so those were removed and will be replaced with clean ones." Also, Koenigsmann explains a bit more, TEA, TEB, LOX and kerosene all need to be introduced in the right order for smooth engine start. If not, can result in some damage. Sensor during GPS-3 detected chamber pressures rising too soon, meaning timing was off. There was also some other information from somebody at NASA about the timeline on Crew 1. The crew are already in a soft quarantine. They will enter a more stringent quarantine on October 31st. Then, November 6th, the crew travels to KSC. After that, the Falcon 9 will test fire on the 9th. They'll do a full launch rehearsal on the 11th. Finally, there's November 14th for launch day. There's also a backup opportunity on the 15th as well. With those updates, we have loads of activity in Boca Chica, starting with these new items that arrived. They were later moved to the orbital launch pad. This huge crane, known as Tankzilla, recently gave SN8 a nose job and has been spotted moving over to the orbital launch pad too. They've been placing further shipping containers in the launch area, although this one won't be part of the wall. Just behind where they are building the wall is Starhopper, which recently got another addition with a new antenna. In the construction area, engineers were seen preparing the roll lifts with some new attachments. There were also some other transporters that were being moved around in the yard. A Starship transport mount was placed on top of these transporters at some point and moved over to the mid bay. Here we have a view of elsewhere in the production area where we can see all sorts of work with ground equipment going on. Looking at pieces of Starship now, SpaceX recently scrapped a whole load of Pathfinder nose cones they had built. The final one was sitting around but has now been moved and scrapped. Spotted sitting out in the yard was a new aft Starship section, possibly for SN10. This section was also moved elsewhere as they worked to build more Starships. It appears that they also did some leg deployment testing with this new section, got to make sure stuff works. Sitting behind the tents is a new upper bulkhead waiting to be mounted and sleeved. Also behind the tents, already on the mount, is a new thrust section that has already been sleeved. In response to tweets from Everyday Astronaut and Chris Burgin, Elon Musk responded about the upcoming test flight. What he said was, "Stable controlled descent with body flaps would be great. Transferring propellant feed from main to header tanks and relight would be a major win." Musk was also asked if the belly flop is the part of the flight he's most concerned about or just the flight in general. He responded with, "Understanding exactly how the body flaps control pitch, yaw and roll during descent such that the ship is positioned well to relight, flip and land would be a big win." When asked if they tested any sort of subscale models of Starship, Musk responded. He said, "We've tested a subscale version in a wind tunnel with active aero closing the loop for stability, so it'll probably work at scale, but reality tends to bite you on the butt." Elon Musk was also asked what could happen if the relight of the engines fail, whether it could land offshore or some other method to terminate flight. Musk responded and said, "Yeah, although if it fails right at the end, some landing pad repair will be needed to fill in the crater." Now we'll take a look at what's going on in terms of SN8 and its next round of testing. It's already performed a static fire with three engines, but not with a nose cone attached, so engineers continue to prepare it. Elon Musk was asked on Friday what we could expect in terms of testing for SN8. He responded and said, "Some challenges with high winds, looks like Sunday for static fire." So with that, here's a view of the road and beach closures we can expect SN8 testing to happen. We have two primary closures to start with, November 1st and 2nd. Then there are backup dates of the 3rd and 4th of November. We are so close now, I'm hoping it won't be long until the Starship flies. Finally for this video, we also have the next candidate getting ready for testing, serial number 9. It was recently moved into the high bay, presumably for flap installation. I'm thinking they might roll out the tank for testing before hooking up the nose. I want to include this here, but Musk was asked if there are differences between SN8 and SN9. Elon Musk said there were minor tweaks to SN9. Outside in the yard, lying on the floor, you can see some pieces with a flap and flap mount. These are surely for SN9. This flap has since been unwrapped as they get closer to installing the fins on this Starship vehicle. This piece of the Starship was then hooked up to the crane in order to be lifted into the high bay and hooked up to the body of SN9. Finally, I also want to show this cool diagram of how the Starship and Super Heavy fleet is currently looking thanks to Brendan Lewis. It goes without saying, but seeing this progress wouldn't be possible without the amazing work from Mary or Boca Chica girl. She and the rest of the NASA spaceflight team make these detailed updates possible, so thank you all. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.